Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. I am Councilwoman Preet Dhidbal, and I am so, so excited about these kids getting through the program. Had wonderful, wonderful PAC 3 weeks. So we are here today as their final day. We have a very special guest, Senator Nielsen, to speak to our kids first, and then we'll go right into our graduation ceremony. We are very, very thrilled with this program and just absolutely excited that we had some wonderful children that actually went through the entire program. They learned a lot. I think at the first couple of days, people were kind of a little shy, but they came out of their shell. Boy, did they come out of their shell last week. So it's been a wonderful experience, and I think they rejuvenated all of us in everything that we do and totally inspired us that we're on the right track. And these are our future leaders, so we're going to support them 100% right behind them. Thank you so much. Senator Nielsen. Did you need a mic, or?
Well,
it's up to you.
Can you hear me okay?
He can't record him, though.
Yeah, I have a little bit of Portuguese. I speak. You're going to record me. All right, well, I tend to speak with my hands, you see. And my wife always says, when you have that microphone, you're going to throw it all the way across the room sometimes, so I have to be a little bit careful. Councilwoman Dhidbal, thank you for allowing me to come and for you to coordinate this. And Supervisor Cleland, thank you. And you have your police chief here, too. You've got a bunch of leaders here helping put this together and motivate you. And you are leaders. You understand that? Yes, you're already leaders, and that's really what this is about, trying to hope and mentor and encourage you to be leaders. Now, by the way, I apologize, I did not wear my jacket over here. In the Senate, we have a rule. We actually voted on it in 1978 when I first became a senator, that you could not appear in the state Senate without a coat and tie. A senator could not be in the Senate or in any committee without a coat and tie. That was the dignity of the House. And today, and I usually wear it all the time, but we were walking over from my office across the street, and I figured this day I could forgive myself to not wear the coat to come over here to speak to you. So no disrespect. I'm a pretty formal kind of guy, and I have another rule that I never loosen my tie until I get into the car for the final event to go home at night. Now, that's just my self-imposed rule. But dignity is a part and a function of leadership. Now, you're way ahead of me when I was your age. In high school and college, all I wanted to do was compete in athletics. I was track and field and football. And go on to college and get a degree in farm. And I did some things. I was an officer in Future Farmers of America, and I think I was a classroom president for a semester or something like that, and a few other minor things. But I didn't have any great aspirations to certainly ever be an elected official. It was not on my mind. I had my opinions. I expressed my opinions, and then you had to be 21 years old to vote, and I voted. And I expressed my opinions, but I realized after I graduated from Fresno State, and I got out, and I left our family farm, and became a foreman on a 33,000 acre farm on the west side of the San Joaquin Valley. And more so than on our small family farm, I began to realize that most of what affected my ability, the farm, even then, and it's vastly more so now than then, was government. And I found out all I was doing was complaining about it. Oh, I was having a great time in the pickup, in the coffee shop, and in the farm shop, complaining about it to my employees and my peers, but that's about as far as it got. Oh, I voted. but that was not making much of a difference. And it wasn't making any difference in the futures for my children. And I realized that I wanted to be an architect of my destiny and theirs, and that I could and should do more than just complain and vote. So I got active in my industry, agriculture, nationwide, doing things all over America, in my community, in community groups, church, civic organizations, school groups, and in a political party, the Republican Party, which I was a part of, became a part of. And I got more and more and more and more involved. And then one day took complete leave of my senses and ran for the state senate. Now, I never ever thought that was something that I was going to do. Pete, you probably didn't either several years ago. But it's something that you're just led to do. And I have found that indeed I have been able to make a bigger difference. To have made a bigger difference in a lot of things that I care about. Not just for agriculture, for education, for libraries, for welfare reform, particularly for water, for things that will affect the lives of my great-grandchildren. A lasting legacy. Every day that I've been a leader, including even this very day, now not as much this day as yesterday or the day before, but every day I get frustrated. But you do not let that deter you. So my challenge to you is to be leaders. Seize the opportunity to, in whatever way, be a leader. Small ways, which can lead to greater ways. But be architects of your destiny. Don't be afraid. And then you can have that warm satisfaction in your heart that you gave it your best. Teddy Roosevelt, a truly great president, put it in this way. One should be in the arena, or out on the field, on the playing field, as I like to put it in my football terms. Be in the arena. Don't be that timid soul that neither knows victory nor defeat. When you fight the good fight, you're going to be defeated sometimes. You're going to win sometimes too. I put it in a football analogy. You're never going to make a touchdown if you're not out on the field. And you're never going to stop anyone else from making a touchdown. I'd rather be out on the field, trying. That's what you can do in your lives. And here you're having a marvelous opportunity to look leadership right in the eye. Now, one of the things I did do was kind of similar to this. We had a day a year at our high school, Sanger High School, that we played city councilman or city official. Now, I can't remember what city official I was, but it was some position. And for that day, we played that city official. And that was kind of neat. And once I got to come up here, and I think I was in the eighth grade, to work in the state senate for a week. Now, really, work meant nothing other than I helped out a state senator who was from the area that I lived in. A stepmother worked for this senator. And I just ran papers around to the different offices. No more than that. But I thought it was pretty cool when I went back to my little elementary school called Centerville, Union Elementary, and people started calling me governor. I thought it was pretty cool. Now, I didn't really know what that meant, but I thought it was a pretty impressive building. But even that did not encourage me to ever think about running and serving in that building. I had no dream that that would ever happen. But I knew it was there. And every week, and nearly every day, classes like you come to the Capitol. And I find my greatest joy of meeting with them and taking them around the Capitol. And I tell them, this is your Capitol. This isn't people like me. We're not the bosses. This is people of California. I represent 1 million people in 9 counties. Over the years I've been a senator, I've represented 19 different Northern California counties. 19. Right now I'm driving around 2,000 to 3,000 miles a month. Many months I've put as many as 4,000 miles a month on my car, driving around the area that I represent. Now, what does representing mean? That gets to my point. Working for you. Most of what my good staff and I do, the staff of Assemblyman Gallagher and Congressman LaMalfa and I, and they work together, is helping you and your families with problems they have with government, helping solve their problems with government. It's not legislation. We do a fair amount of that. And you will too. You get an election elected someday, either in the city council here, but a lot of what Councilman DeBall does, Supervisor Cleland, he deals with legislative matters, but they deal with matters related to the city administration and the county administration, solving your problems. But key word, yours. It is your government. Now, if you don't want to be involved, you want to be apathetic, you don't want to vote, you don't want to pay attention to what's going on in your community, your world, or the nation, that's okay. But understand, you're abdicating, you're giving over to someone else to make the decisions about your future and the future of your family. And in this wonderful country, that's what's precious that we have. We have freedom. We have self-determinism. We have opportunity. I have been in countries where that does not exist. I represent people who come from countries where that does not and has not existed, who have come here to be Americans, naturalized Americans, because they value that freedom. And how sad it is that we take it for granted. Folks, I want to congratulate you for seizing this opportunity. I want to congratulate Councilwoman DeBall and all who have participated in providing you this opportunity. And I want to encourage you, and I want to encourage you in a quote from Shakespeare. Any of you ever heard of Shakespeare? One of his great plays was called Julius Caesar. And in Julius Caesar, there are two key figures, warriors, Cassius and Brutus. And the invading army is out there ready to attack. And Cassius and Brutus are deciding, shall we attack them first or let them attack us and we'll counterattack? And Cassius is saying, let them attack and then we'll counterattack. And Brutus says, no. But he uses the Shakespearean words, there is a tide in the affairs of men or women. If taken at the flood, leads to fortune. Omitted, all the voyage of your lives shall be bound in the shallows and the miseries. What that means now is go for it. Be all that you can be. Don't live your lives in the shallows and the miseries. Seize the opportunity. Do you want any questions, or are we going right into graduation? Do you have any questions? Years old. That was pretty young. I'm tied for being the youngest of the senators ever elected. But, you know, that doesn't mean you can't be younger than I was someday. Early 20s. Yeah. Think about it. Be leaders. And you already have been leaders. Congratulations to you.
So I think we talked about this before, especially our first day, is that my biggest motivation has been you. It's to provide you ways to grow, to become better at what you do, and continue to grow and take those lessons. Remember when we talked about you'll probably take some falls. I take them, I continue to take them, and I have to wipe off the knees, rub off the elbows, and I have to keep going. Exactly what Senator Nielsen said. There's going to be times it's tough, but you know what? Find it in yourself, and you have friendships and relationships out there that will support you. As long as your gut feeling and you are driving your passion, drive what's in you. Dream what you want to dream and go for it. Don't let others tell you how to run your life. Make those decisions, be strong about it, be powerful about it. You're gonna have some falls, and that's okay. That's part of life, that's how you grow. That's how you get the strength. This opportunity came up. I went to a conference last October, and the opportunity was there. Sacramento had started this program. And we continued to talk afterwards. And the reason it got me in the gut, why it felt so right to carry this out and find a way to make this happen, my first opportunity was because of professor told me there was a position, student position, at one of our state departments, and I should go and at least experience it while I was in college and go try it out. I was a pre-med. Where I am today, I cannot explain to you how I got here, but I did, and I am so happy and excited about the work that I do. But it was that professor who led me in a path that I never thought existed. I went into, and it happens to be corrections, so it's a big department, one of our largest departments, and I went in as a student aide to help with physical abilities tests on cadets to get into our academy to be positioned at our institutions. Love the work. I was still in school, waiting to get into my master's, and I ended up meeting the chief of corrections in a fluke at a marathon. And he recognized me as somebody he's seen in the office somewhere, came back to the office, and he happened to need help now in his office. So he contacted the physical abilities OPAS and said, there's a student that comes in, and I know she's only here part-time. Maybe she can help in our office. But sure, I'll help out. Went in to go help. He saw something in me that I never saw, and he directed me to go and take some exams, get involved. I was obviously in the medical field, and he said, we need help in our medical division. I took the exams, I ranked. I was then hired at a higher level in our medical office. I was there for about 6 months. That manager said, okay, wait a minute, you're working on your master's. You should be doing this. And they directed me and guided me. And lo and behold, I'm in management now over a medical unit in correction. And it led on and on, all because of that one contact. So this program meant a lot to me when I heard about it, because it was the opportunity to allow our kids to get in touch with an area that they may never otherwise have that opportunity. So I wanted to open those doors, and I hope all of you have walked away with something, whether it be small or big, but whatever size it may be, all of you have an ability to make an impact in this world. That's a big place, but you can always start at your local community area and make a difference. We're the older people, as my daughter will constantly remind me, and we get into this box. Way things are done, way they should be done. You have the creative thinking. We're still open to those options. You are in that world that is constantly changing, and we may not know exactly what's out there. You can bring those ideas. My position right now, I'm a process improvement advisor for the state. My vision is make ideas a reality. That's my mission statement for my department. And just the other day, I got an email about this program. This person has no idea that that's my vision, my mission statement for what I do with the state. And he put in the email, you made that program a reality. And I went, wow, how interesting is that? Because they saw that it became real. And I want you to carry something. So basically what I'm trying to tell you is, if you feel really good about something, something's just, know you can do something, go for it. Dream big. So what I want to say is congratulations for going through a 3-week program. You know, we put you through a lot. So did it, and today's mock council meeting was amazing. You guys will be on Channel 24 Action News at 5 o'clock. So parents, they were, the news was here. So be ready. So what we want to go ahead and do is, we have a couple of people. I want to thank several people who actually helped put this program together. We couldn't have done it without the help. I always tell people that you can't do anything single-handed. It takes the army to put everything together. So I want to thank Nancy Auberg and Unified School District, who jumped in to help us with coordinating everything. I want to thank the city, Steve, having all the staff just participate. Oh my God, it was just phenomenal with all the job shadowing that we did. It was a great venue. The kids absolutely loved it. I want to thank Randy Page with Sutter County Superintendent's Office. He was an integral part, because I was able to obtain the grant. It's a 3-year grant, so this program is going on for at least 3 more years, and I'm hoping to apply again and get more funding to continue this program and hopefully make it bigger for the entire region. But we got the grant money through Stream Pathways. I know I'm forgetting somebody. Well, Darren's part of our city staff, so there's Brad McIntyre and Darren Gale, who are an integral part of numerous meetings to put all the pieces. They were the glue behind it all. It was a phone call here, text message here, whatever it was. They were like the glue behind everything that was going on. Lauren, Miss E, she has been our instructor for the entire program. And you know what? She was the heart of this program. She made these kids come alive. Like I said, they were in a shell. Within a couple of days, it was like, wow, a whole different personality is coming out. So thank you so very much. With that, I want to go ahead and Robert is here with Yuba City Unified, and I know Nancy had a few words to say, so go ahead, take that opportunity.
Well, thank you. I'm Robert Shemwell. I'm the assistant superintendent with the Yuba City Unified School District. And I want to thank all of you for participating in this program. If you were to step into our offices right now, you would see that we are busy at work planning for the next year of school for students to arrive in August. And we're organizations that plan in years in advance for things. And this is a program that came to us mid-year, somewhere around March. The pieces were coming together. And every once in a while, you get programs like this that come midstream, and you say, geez, we just got to do this. And looking at you all today, sitting here, just makes it that much more of an impactful decision that we all made. Having great community partners, we have the city, we have the County Office of Education, the ROP program, and of course the school district. And again, I just think this is a wonderful opportunity to merge from the world of education, finishing out a school year, coming into the world of work, and kind of marrying those two worlds together, but to add in the world of civic functions and being able to understand just what great things your city provides for you, I think it's just a wonderful opportunity. We had speaking about leadership here, and you guys are all leaders and future leaders. I look at you, and if I had this opportunity at my age, when I was your age, I'd be sitting right in one of those seats there. And I think my colleagues would probably look at this and say, no doubt about it, they would be in these seats. So you have a city planner here, we have council people here, we have senators here, police chief here, and I think every one of us would look at this and say, you know what, we would have jumped on that opportunity if we had it when we were your age. So we appreciate you being here. We're happy to be part of this great collaboration, and look forward to doing it for other years. So congratulations all, and looks like you had a good 3 weeks, because I still see smiles on everybody's faces. So thanks.
Would you like to say anything to your students?
So for those of you that don't know me, I am Lauren Ewert. I am a teacher over at River Valley High School. And I had the great and wonderful privilege of being able to spend the last 3 weeks from 8:30 to 3 o'clock, with the exception of Tuesday, with your students. I could not be more grateful that you have such wonderful children. They are fantastic. They are impressive. They are smart. And it is wonderful to be able to be in this type of position, kind of on the other end of teaching, because it was much more casual. It wasn't that typical teacher-student relationship. It was so much more. And I really had the very rare opportunity of learning from all of you and watching you grow and getting your messages about, I have questions about this, and I want to know more about this, and please get me connected with so-and-so because I want to know more. And your students are incredible people. And I have no doubt that every single one of these students is going to end up doing something fantastic in this world. I have no doubt about that at all whatsoever. You should be very, very proud, because they are fantastic young people, and they're going to be fantastic adults. So thank you guys for this wonderful 3 weeks. It has been my pleasure and my privilege to really see you guys grow and to see you see those light bulbs go off. That is by far, as a teacher, from a teacher standpoint, the coolest thing ever, is to watch those light bulbs go off. So thank you. I'm very proud of you, and that's all I'm going to say.
As both Lauren and I get teary-eyed, it's like, you should have seen us during the mock council meeting, where we're like, oh my God, we're going to cry. We do have a letter from Randy Page. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to be here tonight or this afternoon. And basically, he's on behalf of Sutter County Schools and Tri-County ROP. He wants to express his pride in all of you who have accomplished over the last 3 weeks a phenomenal program. Unfortunately, I am unable to express my thoughts in person, so I've asked to go ahead and express his thoughts here. After 3 weeks, you are on the cusp of completing something special.
You will possess tools that will assist you in your journey of a lifelong learning career that will hopefully guide you as you live, work, and become leaders of our community. You have received great information from a number of key people who will make our who help make our community a great place to live. City council members, county supervisors, the city management staff, your elected officials, Assemblymember Gallagher, Senator Nielsen, and of course your wonderful teacher, Miss E. Wanda, where she's sitting, she is. You have had the opportunity to go through job shadow with members of various city departments to gain an understanding of what city workers do. You have received information on what makes a good employee and information about growing career pathways in your region, including the education and training that you need. It goes on, so please feel free to read the rest, but basically he's saying at the end that go and dream big. If you do everything that you want to, it will happen. Congratulations to all of you, Andy. Okay. So we will go ahead and present each of our students with certificates. If Senator Nielsen can do us the honor of presenting. And we have, Robert, can you do us the honor of calling out their names? Shake with them.
So I will apologize in advance if I mispronounce anyone's name, but I will do the best that I can. Wasim Sandhu. Jacob Perry. Armando Gonzalez Rea. Ivy James. Nolan Otis. Gregory Dunbar. Tom Lee. Allegra Lopez. Zoe Hearn. Christian Ortega. Adriana Villa. Rishiraj Bali. Samantha Coombs. Tommy Bennett Jr. Thank you. Caitlin Coombs. Charisma Lucatero. Navdeep Ball. Michaela Garcia.
Thank you.
Congratulations to each one of you. We do have a couple of students that wanted to share their experiences. So.
Well, I'm really thankful for like everyone who helped put this program together and for like the students coming out. Like you guys and me included, we all worked together just to kind of make this program fun for each of us. And it was really nice being able to go to all the departments and seeing what they do for the city and like how hard everyone works to make this city thrive. And because it's such a small community, I feel like we're all really close to each other. And before this program, all of us came in with some sort of knowledge, just something that makes us each unique. And with us going to different departments to job shadow, we were filled with even more knowledge and we brought it back to this program. And because of that, this program isn't just something that gave us the opportunity to go out and do something different and keep us busy for the summer, but oh gosh, hold on. We filled it with just something about us, and because of that, it just oh gosh, hold on, I'm getting overwhelmed. But because of us contributing different information aspects and just kind of giving it a splash of color, I don't know, it's just something really nice to have with us, and it can give us something to carry out in the future. And because of that, I know more people, I become friends with people that I probably wouldn't have talked to. And I've just met significant, amazing people, and I'm really grateful for that.
Who else?
First of all, P.S., I don't talk to Charisma. I don't know her. But... So I'm Navdeep Ball, and I've had an amazing experience here. And I mean, it was all great, except for maybe the waking up in the morning part during summer vacation, but besides that. And so I could talk for days, so I'll go through some quick highlights real quick. First of all, while we were at the fire department, we actually got to go up in one of the baskets of the fire engine, and we went up like 100 feet in the air, and so the view was amazing. And while we were touring the Fremont Hospital, we actually got to go onto the helipad area, and that was the highest point in Marysville. We also got to sit in an actual courthouse and watch real-life court cases, and trust me, it's nothing like what they show on TV. And just so much more. First of all, the food was amazing, too, and they really spoiled us, so I don't know how I'm going to go back after this. On top of that, we met some very important people and actually got to job shadow some government jobs. We met council members, the city clerk, the city attorney, the mayor, chiefs, and the mayor, and department heads, the city manager and his entire office, honorable judges, a Sutter County supervisor, a superintendent, an assemblyman, and now a senator also. And I actually got to spend a day with engineering and the city manager's office where I job shadowed and learned about their job. And so we're so grateful that so many people took time out of their day to speak to us and give us valuable information and answer all of our questions. And for that, we'd like to thank all of you, and especially thank Ms. E, and Councilwoman Didball, and Londa, who provided food, and every other single person who made this possible. So thank you.
Hello, my name is Adriana Villa. I would first like to thank the members of City Council, Mr. Gale, who's not here, Mr. McIntyre, also not here, Ms. Ewert, Londa, and everyone else without whom this would not be possible. In my application, I wrote, I would absolutely love to gain experience and knowledge required by this, offered by this program. I seek to gain a better understanding of the daily requirements of these amazing contributors to our community and one day hold the power to fill their shoes. And I can honestly say that this program more than surpassed my expectations and opened my eyes to a whole nother world and perspective on government and its effects on the community. I have met some people and built everlasting relationships both within the city of Yuba City and within my high school, River Valley. I have discovered many traits within myself and entire interests that I had no idea I possessed. And without this program, I would have never had the opportunity to experience half of the things I experienced in just these 3 weeks. I'm simply blown away with all of the embrace and support we have received going into all these departments and just taken by the motivation to share every aspect of their daily duties and their will to set aside all of their important things they have to do. I'm forever grateful for all of these human beings that gave up a large portion of their summer to share with us aspiring intellectuals. I am excited for all the endeavors I am approaching both within my near and distant future, and I hope to have the knowledge and support of these individuals to beat on, reach the stars, and land among my dreams. Thank you so very much.
Is there anyone else?
Hi. So I remember on the first day when we came here, one of the first things Miss E asked us, raise your hand if you want to come back here when you're older. And for those of you who have grown up in Yuba City, maybe it wasn't such a surprise that none of us raised our hands. Not a single one of us. But I don't know if I could speak for everyone, but for me personally, that has changed. Every single person that we've spoken to who is a part of this community has been they've just been in love with it, and they have never said a bad thing about it. I haven't talked to one person who had a bad experience in this community, and it was just eye-opening, honestly, to see how loved this community is and how it worked. You know, it's so different, so unique than all the other communities that I've seen, and this program, as well as teaching me so many new things, I think it really opened my eyes into where I'm living and made me appreciate it way more than I would have. So thank you to everyone for that.
I wasn't teary-eyed before. I certainly am now. Because this is my safe haven. This is my home. And so happy to hear that. Anybody else? Or I really start crying.
So my name is Ivy James, and I really wanted to start off by saying it was such a pleasure to get to know all of my peers, really. They're great people. And I also want to thank every one of the family members that are here that have supported them as well. Through this program, I've definitely learned a lot more about local government. And I think I would have never learned about that through just going through the regular courses at school. So I really do want to thank all the council members that put this together, as well as Ms. E. She was a great teacher. And something that I want to get out of this program is that I want to let people know about this in the future. I want this to really keep on going on because it is an amazing program. It really is. And I wish more people will attend it in the future. So really, thank you all.
Is that all of you? Is that all six of you? No? Okay. We have a couple of staff that actually wanted to speak on their experience of having the students in their environment job shadowing. So I think we have one or two staff here that wanted to speak. Lincoln. Oh, that's right. We all should be over there too.
I got to follow this up. You guys are great speakers. Just real quick, my name is Lincoln Eden. I'm with Development Services, and I had the opportunity to have one of the students, one of your children, with me for two separate days, and I actually learned a heck of a lot. Very inquisitive, a lot of questions. I think the partnership that's being built here with the local school district and local government is just fantastic. Understanding how the city works, understanding the functions of the city, how things get done, especially from a council perspective and whatnot. And I've had some unique experiences here myself. I'm a retired police officer here. And so I had that aspect of it, and just learning everything about the city. And I think one, as someone that was with one of the students here, it's, again, just the experience of the questions. And it makes me think. It makes me, okay, the questions, and trying to get answers for them. But what I want to tell them is, all you guys, is you guys have resources here, no matter when, where you are, as you guys go through school, college, and whatnot. Please draw on all these resources at this city and this government. There are so many people here that are more than willing to help you and whatnot, and to be future leaders, which I know you guys all will. And again, congratulations, and thank you guys very much for allowing me to participate in the program. Thank you.
Natalie?
So hi, I'm Natalie Springer. I'm the Human Resources Director. And I just want to thank you and thank the parents. You guys are amazing. You inspired us. We had such a great time. I was at a fire captain's meeting the day after some of you job shadowed, and that's what we were talking about. So really, we're just as grateful as you guys have said thanks to us. I got to tell you, thank you, each and every one of you. We had so much fun. You were inspiring. You created new energy. It was great, and people couldn't quit talking about you. And thank you, parents and loved ones, for supporting them, because they're all amazing. They have great energy, lots of good stuff. If you ever want to come, you have my card. They're up front. We can do mock interviews, whatever support you need to be successful in the workplace. Human Resources will be, a resource for you. If not myself, my staff, because we do want to see you successful. I hope you have a good idea of all the careers that are out there for you. And we can't wait till you get in the workforce. So in the meantime, you know what I'm going to say, right? Be kind.
I think that was it, right? Any of the other staff? No? Okay. All right. With that, we just wanted to, Lauren.
Yeah. Ariana, can you please, I know you already are saying this, okay?
So before, I can't take credit for everything. I am only one person, and Londa organized all of my food. So for 3 weeks, trying to make sure breakfast and lunch happened and was here, and so that your kids were fed, Londa literally ran all over Yuba City, making sure that everything was arranged. So thank you, Londa, for all your help and all your support. Now, for those of you that don't know Minnie Preet, this wonderful woman, Ariana, helped me do everything. She was like my TA for the summer, which she didn't even realize she was going to be doing until her mom volunteered her to do it. But she has literally been my right hand. Every time I needed something, she'd go and print something out. She'd go and get coffee. She'd make sure I was awake and here and present so that I could be this normal, crazy person that I normally am all the time. So thank you for your help, for running around, for being their ears also, because I know a lot of the times they wanted to come and talk to you and let you know what was going on. So thank you both. This program definitely would not have been as successful without you. Okay, where's the cake? Okay. Too much food already. We had a big barbecue at lunch outside. Yes. We'll take another one with them having their certificates. But for all the students, we have gift bags for you as well with little goodies. And for the parents, as you already know, we are very, very excited about tomorrow's trip. We will be on the road to Sacramento. First thing in the morning, we have a special tour at the governor's office. So that's their finale. They get to go and tour something that is not usually open to the public. So we got them behind the scenes tour. And then in the afternoon, we will go to Old Sac and have a great lunch. Then we will give them a couple of hours to kind of go and do their thing and probably get some more ice cream, some more chocolate, and be on like sugar high on the bus trip back. So be forewarned, that may happen. They may be on a complete sugar high. But again, I just want to say thank you so very much for allowing your children to be a part of this program. It meant a great deal to us. It meant the world to them to be a part of an opportunity that's far in between. And like some of them had said, that their experience was very well taken, and I hope to grow this program so that we have more students and open it up to our entire region. So spread the word. You are all firsthand, first year, and the other great part is that the program has become well known already. Like I said, it's going to be on the newscast this evening, but we have already been asked by League of California Cities to come back in the October conference, which means we will represent the California cities with this program and hopefully be able to launch this program in every California city across. So we are putting Yuba City on the map. And these kids are actually going to be represented during that conference. So they are videotaped. We've interviewed them one-on-one. So they'll be all over in that conference. But thanks to the kids, you guys made this so successful, so thank you.